The question gives the pH and wants us to find three things: concentration of H plus and OH minus, as well as the pOH. I've posted a video explaining the six formulas that we can use for pH calculations, and we'll be using a few of them here. Since we already have the pH, we can use this formula to find H plus. We can also start with this formula to find pOH. Now, it doesn't matter which formula we start with because we need to find both values anyway, so I'm just going to go with the first one. The first formula we'll use is H plus is equals to the anti-log of negative pH. We plug in 8.6 for pH, so we get anti-log of negative 8.6, and that comes up to be 2.5 times 10 to the power of negative 9 molar. Don't forget the unit. From the calculated H plus concentration, we can then easily find the OH minus concentration. And we do that by using this relationship formula. So we plug in 2.5 times 10 to the power of negative 9 for H plus, and we do the division, and we get OH minus concentration is 4.0 times 10 to the negative 6 molar. Now that we've found the value for OH minus, we can use it to find pOH. We take the negative log of 4.0 times 10 to the negative 6, and that gives us 5.40. Since there's no unit for pH and pOH, so we'll just leave this number as is. Now, this is one of the ways to find pOH from OH minus. Another way is to find it directly from the pH. That was the second formula that I mentioned earlier. So we plug in the given pH and we get 5.40. Both values for pOH should be the same regardless of the method that we use. To recap, here's the strategy we use to calculate the values for H+, OH- and pOH. We started from the given pH and we found the value for H+ concentration. And from the H+ concentration, we look for the value for OH- concentration. From that value, we found the pOH. And in fact, that's not the only way. There's another way, which is from pH directly, we can figure out what's the value of pOH. Now, it doesn't matter which way we use, as long as it brings you from what the question gives you to what you need to find. You may not need to find all three values. I just want to show you how they are all interrelated. I hope the video helped you out somehow. Do subscribe, and thanks for watching.